Mr. Excel Podcast is sponsored by Easy Excel. Don't Fear the Spreadsheet Podcast, episode number 17, Insert Text Files to Excel. Well, hey, welcome back to the Don't Fear the Spreadsheet Podcast. I'm Bill Jelen from Mr. Excel. And today's question, Tyler Nash.
I have several files that I need to import into Excel. Is that even possible? Can I import files into Excel?
Sure, Tyler. Excel can import files. Now, the book talks about files that are in one of these formats, either .prn, .txt, or .csv. Prn files traditionally are space delimited, so everything's kind of lined up, you know, so the region starts here, and then the date starts here, and the customer starts here, revenue here, and profit here, so it kind of looks like this, especially if you look at it in a nice monospace font. Notepad is good for that, or a CSV file has a comma between each field. And you have to be careful if there was a customer name that had a comma in it, like Tickling Keys, comma, Inc., they would have to put that in quotes to make sure that that comma wasn't treated as a separate field. So Excel can deal with all these. Also, another real common one is they'll put a tab between, and that's a little frustrating. You can't really tell when they put the tab between because the tab doesn't show up all the time, depending on what you're viewing the file in. So let's take a look in Excel here how we can deal with this. You could always use File, Open, and go find it, but you could also now do Data from Text. And the nice thing about Data from Text is you can put it wherever you want. So if I want that text file to go right there, we'll say From Text, and they'll bring up the choices here. It's showing us all of the Prn, TXT, and CSV files. Let's start with some data. Click Import, and it'll take us right through the Import Text wizard, which is three steps. So here we'll start with Delimited, click Next, and Tab is chosen by default. All right, so now that's cool. They show you what the where the tabs are, and that looks good. Step three, and they want you to go through, and for each of these fields, say what you want to do with it. Well, this one out here looks like it's blank, so I'm going to say Do Not Import. This one is blank, Do Not Import. And this one is a date, so you're tempted to come here and choose date, but in fact, you don't have to do that if it's in month, day, year format, or if you're in the UK, day, month, year. If it matches your regional settings, then you can just leave it as general, and it'll come in correctly. If someone wrote it out as year, month, day, well, yeah, then you're going to have to choose date and change. But if it, you know, it's just a regular old date, it's going to come in just fine. And we click Finish, click OK, and there is the data from that file. All right, so that's the tab delimited. Let's try it again with that the CSV file. So more data, CSV, this has a comma. Delimited this time. The delimiter is a comma. I've seen all kinds of weird delimiters. If they put something strange in here that's not a space, a semicolon, you can actually click other and type what that delimiter is. See, a lot of people use the vertical pipe, that vertical bar over there above the enter key. All right, so again, we'll just leave all of this as general. Click finish. Click OK, and there's our second text file. Now let's try the last one. We'll try it again from text. And other data.prn. Now this one is different. This is the one, remember, where everything was lined up. And Microsoft goes through in step two and tries to figure out where the items break. And because date and customer, date was right aligned, customer was left aligned, are right next to each other, they didn't get that correct. So we'll want to click here and add a new field. And you can move things, like for example, East Central West. I'm not sure that line will accommodate Central, so I'll drag it to the right. I know that that way, you know, we have the characters that we need for date. Although now as I start to think about it, I'm going to cruise down through. Ah, they actually did have it at the right spot. Started thinking about dates that might be a little bit longer. So you can always look through the data. General Electric. Is that the longest customer name? This is always a little, you know, a little bit of experimentation to try and make sure that you got it in the right spot. Click Next, and again, here we'll leave everything as general. Click Finish, and the data comes in. I would probably want to sort this by revenue, A to Z, Z to A. Oh, right there, SBC communication. See that S slipped over, so that's a problem. I need to go through and edit that. I'll put the S back at the end of this cell and take it out of this cell. And I found that by sorting ascending and descending, anything that's not numeric will sort to the top. And so I was able to spot that problem. All right. So, yes, Tyler, you can import text files in many different formats. You just need to be a little bit careful as they're coming in. A long time ago, I remember a fellow in marketing sent me a file and he didn't know the rule about the commas. And so, all of the customers that had a comma, he didn't put quotes around the data. And, the first part of the customer name showed up here, everything after the comma showed up here, and then there was one extra column. Revenue in this column, profit out here. So you just want to take a look at that data, scan through it, make sure that it looks good before you start creating analyses with it. All right, hey, check out Don't Fear the Spreadsheet, 200 full color pages, $14.95. It's the world's easiest book on Excel. This book makes Excel for dummies look like it was written for rocket scientists.